The season we are in demands the extraordinary. Something radical has got to happen. Something's going to happen that shakes and moves everything.
Because Jesus. in the house. Come on and praise him tonight. Oh, we lift our praises unto you, O Lord. You alone are worthy. You alone are worthy.
Praise the name of Jesus. Now tonight the Lord said to me, I want you just to quote my word and speak just for a few minutes on greater things.
Yes.
And then once we've spoken about them, we'll do them.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen. We'll speak about it for a few seconds, greater things. And once we've spoken about it, then we'll do them. Is that okay? And where does this come from? The Lord Jesus speaks. And he says to his disciples, truly, truly, I say unto you, whoever believes in me will also do the works that I do. Did you read about what Jesus did? Did you read about what Jesus did?
Amen.
Just listen to this. Truly, truly, I say to you, whoever believes in me will also do the works that I do.
Amen.
Did he specify something? Did he say that, you know, you'll lead people to Christ, or you'll go out preaching on the streets, you'll do this, A, B, C? Doesn't sound too, if I read it right, he just says, we'll do the works that I do.
Amen. Hallelujah.
And then he says something really startling. He goes on, he says, and greater works than these will he do. And then he gives the reason why. He says, because I am going to my Father.
Yes, hallelujah.
In other words, what Jesus is saying is, if I was around, you see, because Jesus never did less, he always did more. When he raised people from the dead, he started by just walking past the casket. First he went into a room and he raised the dead girl. And then the next time he walked down the street publicly and he just touched the casket. And a boy revived. And then later on, we follow him through his life and we find him at Lazarus' gravesite. And we find that he allowed him purposefully to start rotting.
Yes.
Left him there for days.
Yes.
And then called him out.
Because
God always works in greater dimensions of his glory. So Jesus is saying, if I was here, there's some things you haven't seen. Because in another portion of scripture, he says the following. He says, for the Father loves the Son and shows him all that he himself is doing. Listen carefully. For the Father loves the Son and shows him, the Son, all that he, the Father, himself is doing. Because you remember that Jesus said, I only do what I see my Father doing. I only say what I hear my Father say. And now he says, and greater works than these will he show him, will he show me, the Son, so that you may marvel.
Yes, hallelujah.
Do you hear that? Jesus is saying, he says, listen, everything I do, I see my Father. He shows me certain things, and I do as I see. And people are stunned. He said, what you've seen up to now, he says, he's going to show me greater things than these. He'll reveal to me greater things. I'll see him do greater things. Greater things are going to happen. That's going to be revealed through me because I'll do what I see. It's going to be higher dimensions, greater glory. And I'm going to do it and you'll be shocked to see what I'm going to do. This was while he was still on earth. Then he goes away and he says to his disciples, he says, listen, the works that I've done, whoever believes in me will do the same works and greater works than these, because I'm not going to be around to do them. I'm going to my Father. But don't be sorrowful, because I'm sending the same Spirit that dwelt in me. The same Spirit is going to come and dwell inside of you, and greater works will be done, because the revelation the Spirit gave me, he's going to give you, because he's not coming to testify of himself. He's coming to take from me, so it will still be me doing the works through you, and there's greater stuff I want to do than I've ever done on this earth. Through the power of the Holy Spirit. This is me and my Father will come and live inside of you. Listen, if you've got Jesus inside of you, you've got the greater one walking inside of you. And he said there's greater things that needs to be done. Greater things. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, part of the reason I'm touching on this tonight, I want to bring it home to you. Because you're the one that is talking about whoever will believe in me.
Yes, hallelujah.
Whoever will believe in me, the works that I do, he will do also. And greater works than these, because I go unto my Father.
Yes.
Then he speaks of the Holy Spirit that will come and indwell us. And Paul says we have this treasure hidden in earthen vessels.
Yes.
He says the glory of the Lord abides in us. He says the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead now lives inside of us. He brings it back to the Holy Spirit. Jesus says, listen, the Spirit that dwelt in me will dwell in you.
Yes.
And when we start talking about the power of God, many times people connect the deity of Christ, the Godskap van Christus, die feit dat hy God is, konnekteer hulle met die krag van God. Many times people connect the deity, the godliness of Jesus, they connect with the power of God, which is completely wrong. It's wrong. It's not the power of God that made him the Christ. It's not the power of God that made him God. What made him God is that he was born of a virgin.
Yes.
Are you listening to me? It was not the power that made him God. What made him God is that he was born unlike any other man on the face of the earth would ever be born. He was born directly out of heaven. The Holy Spirit imparted Jesus into Mary, and he was born the only begotten Son of God. No other one that made him King of Kings. It reserved him as the Lord of Lords forevermore. So there's nothing to dispute about Jesus. Whether he was doing mighty acts or not, he was forever the Son of God. No other man would be born that way. No other man would ever be able to be compared with Jesus. He was born in a manner that was set apart by God forever. It wasn't the power of God. It was his deity. It was the way he was born.
Hallelujah.
Can you accept that tonight? Can you accept that the power of God is not what made him God?
Yes.
What made him God was that he was born as the Christ.
Amen.
He was born as the Christ.
Yes.
Now, when we speak about the power of the Holy Spirit, we see Jesus being born into flesh. The Bible says he laid down his glory.
Yes.
And he took on human flesh. We see him as an ordinary man, yet set apart by God.
Yes.
We see him doing the things ordinary men do, living an ordinary life. Then one day we see Jesus called down to the Jordan by the Holy Spirit. His Father speaks to him. He hears a word from the Father that calls him to the Jordan. When he comes into the Jordan, he is baptized as the originator of the gospel. As he comes out of the water, the Bible says
The heavens opened and the Spirit of God descended upon this man. Are you listening to me? This man, this ordinary man, yet God in the flesh, but ordinary like any other man. He never performed miracles. He never did anything extraordinary. He worked as a carpenter. He lived among men. He had a father and a mother in the natural, although he wasn't born from the father. He had a stepdad that took care of him. He lived an ordinary life. Suddenly the heavens open and the Holy Spirit descends in the form of a dove, and the power of God, the Spirit of God, fills him. From that moment on, the Son of God, who was the Son of God before the Holy Spirit came, who was the Son of God before the power of God came, who was the Son of God settled before any miracles was done, he was born of a virgin, the Son of God. All of a sudden, this ordinary man is filled with God's power and he becomes extraordinary in everything he does. Miracles are performed. He goes into the temple. He makes an announcement in Luke chapter 4. He says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, to preach liberty to the captives, to set them free, to declare the favorable year of the Lord. He says that prophecy today. I want you to walk with me through this. Listen. Jesus says that day in the temple, he says, today, this prophecy is fulfilled in your ears.
Yes, amen.
Can you see that there is a place where the power of God and the deity of Christ walks next to each other? In other words, my brother, my sister, many people say that we are not supposed to do the things that Jesus did because he was Jesus. I need to tell you that you are wrong. He was Jesus before he did those things. He was God before he did those things. You are totally wrong. It's not those things that made him God. He was God from the day he was born and he was birthed in the womb of Mary. It was God in the flesh. It's got nothing to do with what he came to do on earth. He was born God. He takes 12 men on a journey. He says, follow me and learn of me. Let me show you. They come to him when they fail. They say, God, why? Jesus, why couldn't we do this? Why couldn't we cast the devil out of him? They're asking him questions. They're in a training program. He's teaching them how to perform, how to act, how things work. Suddenly they can't get something right. They say, teach us, what did we do wrong? Can you see that? Can you see that it's not about the works? He is Jesus.
Amen.
The works came by revelation of the Spirit. The greater works happened because the Holy Spirit connected him to the Father and he started walking in direct revelation with the Father. Whatever God did in heaven, he performed on earth. And mighty, powerful results flowed from the throne, touched people's lives. Demons were cast out, cripples walked, the lame was restored. Do you know why? Because it's the heart of God for people to be whole. He wants you to be whole. He wants you to be healed, to be well, to be blessed. He created you for the best. So Jesus teaches his disciples. They walk with him. And he says, watch what I do and then see how it works. And remember, when I go, remember this message, preach it all over the world, that whoever believes in me, the same Spirit that dwells in me will come to dwell in them, and greater works than these shall they do. Because I go unto the Father, I am the firstborn among many brethren. None of them will ever be able to compete with me. We are not in a competition. I am the only begotten Son of God. I am King of Kings. I am Lord of Lords. My place is settled at the right hand of the Father. I went down, took the keys of hell, took the keys of death and sin, destroyed the enemy, came out victoriously, ascended to heaven, and I'm seated next to my Father, and every name shall bow, and every tongue shall confess, and I know power. So when they go, don't ever tell them that they are in competition with me. Don't ever tell them they cannot do what I did. I said they will do it at greater. They will never be able to compete with me. I am God. My place is settled. I'm not fighting for a position.
Hallelujah.
It's settled. Now go and do the works. Go and do the greater works.
Hallelujah.
Go in my name. Declare liberty to the captives. Go in my name. Heal the sick. Go in my name. Cast out devils. Amen. Jesus wants us to walk in His power. That's why He died on the cross. That's why He says, you are my brothers. Don't be ashamed to be called so. He says, I'm the firstborn. We've got no competition between us.
Hallelujah.
He says, I'm the firstborn among many brethren. So I am tonight standing here. I'm a brother of the King.
My man. Hallelujah.
I'm a brother of the King. He's my King, He's my Lord, He's my Savior. I am family. I'm one with Him, and the same Spirit that dwelt in Him is given unto me.
Thank you, Lord.
It dwells in me.
Yes.
We are one in the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
He's in me, and I am in Him.
Yes.
And He's commanded me. He's commanded me greater things.
Hallelujah.
I want to perform through your life. Don't hold back. Don't be intimidated. Don't fear that you might outdo me. You can never outdo me. It will always be me performing the works in and through you. Because remember, without me, you are nothing.
Amen.
Isn't it wonderful?
Hallelujah.
Greater works. Greater works. Do you hear me tonight? God has got no problem with it when you do greater works than what Jesus has done. He wants you to live there. He wants us to live in that place. He wants us to be in the place of power.
Yes, hallelujah.
He wants us to be in the place where we, like Jesus, will hear what He says and speak it. And when we speak those words, it will be like a blade sharper than any two-edged sword that will cut into the hearts of men, that will touch where no human tongue can go, that will crush the hardest heart, that will mend the broken heart, that will lift people up and restore. That word that carries power, that will make demons flee. That word that carries the healing authority, that will say, thy daughter is home.
Hallelujah.
In that minute, all circumstances change miles away. Demons flee miles away. Restoration power is released. Amen. He wants us to walk in the greater things.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Are you excited?
Yes.
Praise God. Now let me bring it down to a practical level. You need to move with me now. Move that machine. Don't get lost in the service. Stay with me. Ek sien hy verdwaal so 'n bietjie dan as dan sou weer kan sê daarin. Don't get lost. You watch the video. Let me make it practical to you tonight. People have said to me, now why do you blow on people? Why do you blow on people? So, well, I don't know, you know, it's just by revelation. In that moment, I
feel the Spirit of the Lord just wanting to breathe on somebody. So I blow on them. I said, but is there scripture for that?
Yes.
Jesus blew over his disciples. He said, receive the Holy Spirit. I said, but you know Jesus, you know. You know Jesus. Can you see the problem when people connect the deity of Christ to the power of God?
Right.
Because it was Jesus that did this, we cannot do it. Because it was Jesus, but we're not that powerful. It was Jesus, we can't walk there, you know, because that was Jesus. It's not for us. We can never be on the same level because it was Jesus. Can you see that tonight? We connect the power of God to the deity of Christ, to the lordship of Christ. He was Lord before he became the vessel of the Holy Spirit and power. You don't have to be scared that you're going to outdo Jesus. He wants to outdo himself through you. He wants to outdo the works that he did. The world needs to see a greater revelation of the power of God than ever before. We need a shaking that people will wake up and know God is alive. Personally, I'm waiting for the dead to be raised. I'm waiting for that. I'm trusting God not to raise them one by one.
Yes, hallelujah.
I'm trusting that coffins will be carried into my meetings 50 at a time.
Yes.
I'm trusting that the power of God will come and rattle and shake everything, raise the dead for the glory of Jesus. Why not?
Yes.
Why not?
Amen.
We need the power of God.
Amen.
You know, I believe before those things start happening, and trust me tonight, they're going to happen. Trust me, they're going to happen.
Yes, hallelujah.
Before God sent me out there to make them happen, he said, I'm sending you to my own house first.
Yes, amen.
He said, I want you to go to my own house and ignite them, prepare them, tell them what's coming, wake them up, tell them I'm about to move, things are about to happen.
Yes, amen.
Set them ablaze. Get their hearts ready. So when my spirit starts working, they will be ready to receive the harvest. The people will not be brought into a tomb, but into a whoop. That they will be brought into a place alive with the fire of God, ready to receive them, ready to incubate them, make them grow strong.
My God, yes.
We are in that season. God is shifting. God is moving. He's kicking the devil right out of the door.
Amen.
He's kicking them out of people's lives. Out of people's lives, bound with depression, oppression, problems, all the things of the world that's coming, sat like a big fat old woman, sat on their head. God is kicking that out, saying, I'm raising my people up to my power. Getting them ready. They're the called, they're the anointed, they're the overcomers. I'm going to touch them with new fire. I'm going to anoint them from heaven. They're going to become victors. They're going to run with my fire. They'll be ready for the harvest. They lead, others will follow them.
Yes, amen.
Are we there right now? Right, this very moment. We are in that movement.
Yes, amen.
This Lady Smith, God's preparing a house, a people. This is not about a church anymore. I don't care what's written outside. We will have to learn to kick down the walls.
Yes, amen.
Because God is restoring his body bone by bone, bringing them back together. The breath of heaven is released in the valley. The bones are coming together. People are being connected. All the dead, dry bones are catching fire. Denominational boundaries are destroyed by the power of God, trampled.
Yes.
Just like that old snake was trampled, so God is trampling all of these things.
Yes.
That's keeping us from being one.
Yes,
and Pastor, as we move all of a sudden find out in the spirit.
Yes.
Connections happening.
Yes.
Spirit connections. All of a sudden I come to this man and don't move the camera. I go, I find out, my God, yes. And I find out, another connection. God, but they're not even from the same church.
Hallelujah.
Let me not miss you.
Yes, hallelujah.
All of a sudden, we see the body coming together.
Yes.
God, His Spirit, it's not the work of a man.
Yes.
It's the moving of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
The breath of God.
Glory
to God. And in the valley of the wind goes.
Yes.
And we hear a rattling.
Yes.
Bones coming together.
Thank you.
Praise God. Amen. The alarm bells in hell. Spirit, the same Spirit, the same Spirit. you just get a mustard seed into your own heart? Can you tell the devil it's out with you, it's in with Jesus? No longer will you have that authority over my life. I will no longer stand defeated. Something is changing. Something is happening in my life. It's my moment. Bone by bone. I'm one of the bones. And God is connecting me to what? To his body. What is his body connected to? To his anointing. To the oil. To the horn. To the heart.
Yes, Amen.
To the place where the oil flows.
Oh,
and as it flows, the Bible says the anointing oil flowed from the head of the Aaron. It said it flowed all the way down. All this, God doesn't do half a job. All the way down, it soaked his clothes, his body, right into his very footsteps. It made bundles of oil. God is going to anoint you from head to toe. Everything in your life is going to be affected and changed and anointed.
Amen.
Can you say amen?
Amen. Amen. Sir, God wants to heal that day. Look at me, turn around. Kijk voor mij. Stap nu dan toe, God wil je gezond maken.
Die kracht van de Heer niet verdiend waar je gekomen bent. Die Heer moet los in de naam van Jezus. En die naam van Jezus spreekt een bevrijding in alle dieren. Die kracht van de Heer, God maakt je los. God maakt je los. Los in Jezus naam. En die is de kracht van de Heer. En dan is die het ook van God genees. Vrije komt dan op mijn kinderen van los in de naam. Van die vader is lessen, lessen.
Let a mighty Nou, ek weet, hulle lê op in die militaire school is, kyk al. Hulle lê net seker seker lekker reguit lyne langs mekaar. Drink ou noentjie, drink, die gees van die Here maak jou vol. Drink, die gees van die Here maak jou vol. Drink goed dan, is nou of nooit. Sluk.
Because Jesus,
You alone are worthy.